For the longest time, I suffered from my Git workflow. It was manual and unintuitive. I had aliases and tried GUIs, but neither helped much. Until I figured Vim has Fugitive and Telescope, and then Git-Signs. My workflow connected into this one beautiful experience, and that's what I want to share with you today. Fugitive is one of Vim's most famous plugins. It was written by Tim Pope. If you don't know who Tim Pope is, I highly recommend you check his GitHub profile. Together with Git-Signs plugin and Telescope, we're going to see how to upgrade your Git flow today right from Neovim itself. With Fugitive, the most important command is git. That used to be git status, today is just git. This is the main screen that shows you the git status, what files have changed, which are tracked, stage for commit, etc. You can see I have two lists of untracked and staged files, meaning files that Git isn't aware of and files that are tracked but have changes and are not yet staged for commit. Let's see what else Fugitive can do for us. Git help shows the list of options, which basically cover almost any Git functionality you can dream of. Back to the status panel, let's see why it is so powerful. I pick the DSStore file and hit dash. You see that it's gone from the untracked list because I've just git added it. I can also visually mark multiple files. Here I'm doing it with Shift V and the down motion to select two files. I'll hit the same key again to add them. Notice that one of them is a directory. It ends with a slash. So now I can see all the files underneath it, also part of the commit. Another beautiful feature is an inline presentation of the commit. If I stand on one of the files and hit the equal sign, I get the commit change description with the lines change and the surrounding code. If I hit enter, the file pops in the other buffer to the side. Notice that I have the signs to the left showing me lines that were added or changed. This is done with the Git-Signs plugin. Let's see how it integrates nicely with the comparison tool by running Gvdiff. V is just a vertical sign, you can lose the V and do the same with the horizontal split. So now I have two panes comparing the changes, which I can see are just indentation of the code done by probably GoFMT. If you're looking at this thinking to yourself, this very much resembles a pull request diff tool, you're perfectly right. We can easily use it to compare branches. Just run gvdiff with the branch name and see the changes. In my Neovim Lua configuration that you can find on GitHub, by the way, I have mapping that are using the close bracket and C to jump to the next change and the opening bracket and C to jump to the previous change. So with that, I can scroll through the document, jumping between changes and following the diffs that are offered by Fugitive. Another Fugitive feature is the ability to write an entire file, which is equivalent to git add a file name. This will change the entire file and stage it for commit, rather than specifying parts of it for the next commit. We can now see it's reflected in the status buffer. Gread will actually do the opposite. It will read the last changes, which is equivalent to running git reset. I'll hit undo to keep my changes in the working copy for now. Let's check out git log. Similar to the status, I can now see an open pane of history commits and some metadata. I'm quickly changing the splits to vertical. And now when I hit enter, I can see the actual changes that belong to that specific commit. Git blame will show me the committers to the left with the date and time, so I can follow who did what. Another nice addition by Git-Signs is being able to toggle a deleted hunk. So with TD as a shortcut, I can see the older change, which is an unindented three lines that appear in a marked brown area. Hitting again TD will hide them back. Another switch I can toggle is showing inline git blame. So with TB now, I will have the lines that I'm standing on show the last commit and the timestamp. It's time to commit something. I'm going to find.go and gwrite to the entire file. This is not my usual workflow. I try to only add hunks that make sense in a certain commit. This file now appears as staged. With git commit, I get another pane ready to hold my commit message. A shorter version of that would be just adding minus M and your message, but I want to first go through the basic ways. Once I approve that, down below I can see the commit summary, and we can also see it's now part of the log. let's check out what Telescope can do for us here. If you don't already know Telescope, you'll find a link in the description for a video with one of its creators to walk you through the installation and everything you need about it. So Telescope can show us a few Git options in its fuzzy finder window. The first interesting one is a view of the Git status. Notice how I can visually see both untracked and staged for commit files, as well as their diff preview to the right. I can of course use the fuzzy text search to filter out my results. The next useful option is viewing the commits, which is essentially a Git log in a fuzzy search. I can go through commits, filter them, and see the changes immediately. The last one I'm using is Git branches. I don't have many here, but when you do, it's a breeze to search with compared to other tools. It's worth exploring all of Git-Signs functionality, like the blame box, the option to toggle the signs on and off for focus mode, and tons of more interesting things. Let's quickly check out some of Vim's configuration for the signs plugin. Here I'm showing the brackets with C that helps me scroll through changes back and forth, and the rest of the shortcuts that I've used to stage hunks, reset them, toggle blame, toggle deletions, etc. Most of these are taken from the project's defaults, and others I've added myself. Again, I'm just mentioning that you can find all of it on my .files on GitHub. I want to conclude the video with a real-life workflow of how I use the plugins to stage and commit my changes. I'm standing on the change that I want, and I use leader hs to hunk stage. With the brackets and C, I'm then jumping between changes. I'll only add the last change to the init function. I'll check the status as always and see that I have only one unpushed change and another ready to be committed. I'll preview it with the equal sign, and since it looks good, I'll git commit it with a quick message. After committing, I'll git push it to my repo. Thank you for watching. I'll soon release another video with the very useful feature of Fugitive, which is solving the painful process of merge conflicts. I thought it deserves a video of its own, so subscribe and stay tuned.